Hi, my name is David, and in our last video we have shown you how to unbox and set up and first install the Ghost Pro printer, the latest biggest SRA3 printer from our portfolio. And in today's video I quickly want to walk you through the installation of the standard printer driver on my PC, and I want to show you some basic settings that you can make. Remember last time when we set up the printer, we did configure the network settings automatically on the screen of the printer on the little display, and the printer did show us the IP address, and by the IP address of the printer we can easily access all the settings directly by just popping the IP address into a web browser. This is exactly what we're going to do now. We're going to head over to the screen and we're going to open the printer on the browser and we're going to check the settings there. So let's head to the screen. Okay, I open up the Chrome web browser here and I type in the IP address which the printer showed me in the installation. Press enter and immediately the printer web page wakes up and you can see that you get a nice picture of the printer. You get some basic information like the name and the IP address. You can see that you got some notifications here. You got an overview about your paper trays here. You get the info that we don't have any paper in the printer at the moment. Tray 1 is set to A4, tray 2 is set to A3. Printer recognizes that. All our toner cartridges are on 100%, and we've actually not printed a page yet, so this printer is brand new. And you can also access all the pending jobs here. It's got like a job list. You can see that it didn't print any jobs, just the initializing job from the startup of the printer. So this is actually where you can also access some settings. If you just enter as an admin, you will pop in the admin password and make some settings. We won't do that for now. We will just head to the install files for the printer. So the printer comes with a CD-ROM and with a USB flash drive. I've opened the flash drive here. It actually does contain some presets for PowerPoint, Illustrator, Publisher, Word, and a color reference card. We will talk about that in another video. And I've already downloaded the smart installation driver. So I just open that. Windows asks me if I want to allow changes and I say yes. And now the printer installation will start. First, it asks for my confirmation of these terms and agreements. We just read that quickly and install it, and it already says that it wants to install this printer, and we just say quick install. Now it will find the printer in the network automatically. You can see the IP address down here, and it now installs all the drivers and the software automatically onto your computer. That just takes a while. You see it spinning here. It now gives you information that the installation has finished successfully. You can see that it installed the global PostScript driver and the printer queue. You could start printing a test page, install another printer, or you just say done. And for now we'll just say done, and we quickly confirm that we have the printer installed. I open my system preferences here and then I go to printers and I can see all my printers listed here. And you will see that I got the printer listed here. I think after a quick restart, it will also get a nice printer icon like these other ones here. But you can see that I've got my Ghost 150 printer and all other printers listed here. So it has been successfully installed. And I'll just make a right click on it and I say printer settings. Just want to quickly go over the settings. You can see it's got a name and it's got different settings like any Windows printer got. We're not going into the details yet. After installing the printer driver, I just restarted my computer to make sure that everything is installed. And now I just want to quickly make a test print from Microsoft Word. I've prepared a file on my screen, which I'm about to show you now. So this printer does know that it's got a white cartridge. This printer has white as an option in the printer driver, as you will quickly see on my screen. And it's really easy to use your standard office software, like for example Microsoft Word, to create designs for this printer, which can be printed on dark media. For this quick example and test print, I'm going to use a sheet of A4 black matte paper, and I'm going to insert this into the side tray of the printer. The bottom tray is also loaded with the same paper at the moment, but for now I'm just opening the side tray by pulling it open here and inserting one sheet or two sheets, few sheets of this paper. And now we're heading to the screen. I open my sample design here in Microsoft Word. We will make separate videos on the designing later, where we explain to you step by step what you have to bear in mind when you create designs for this printer. But as you can already see, this design has a blank white background, some designs elements in yellow, and some text elements in white. If I just click into this text field, you see that there is some text in white. I can change the color to red, and then you see it's going to be red. I'm going to change the color here as well to red, and here as well to red, and here as well. All the other colors I leave white, and we will see how that prints. So I just go to the print dialog in Microsoft Word. It automatically selects my printer, and I want to only print the pages 1 and 2, so I type that in here. Then I go to printer settings to make my detailed settings for this application. It immediately comes up with this dialog where you can actually choose what kind of paper, what kind of color, and what type of paper you want to print on. And we're gonna change that. We're gonna say we want to print on A4, that's fine, but we want to print on a different color. The paper is thought to be black, and it's a normal standard paper, no cardstock or anything here. And then for toner settings, we are going to say settings for black paper, like here, and we leave the background to automatic background. This will remove the background and will give a blank background, so it will not print a white in the background. And then we select single sheets because we don't want this to be printed in duplex mode. Okay, and then we just hit OK and we hit print. The printer immediately wakes up, warms up, and starts pulling paper from the paper tray. And as you can see, the prints come out real quickly. So I just move around here and they came out in the lower paper option. And now let's see how these prints came out. So as you can see, the printer has adapted my reds, which I just changed on the go in the document, and did actually apply the whites and white and the blacks he took from the background of my paper, and the yellow lines are yellow just as it was in the design. So as you can see, we've got some really nice color output here. Some really nice white and some really nice color just in one run. Really, really good. This is how easy you can, you know, make your first prints using Ghost Pro with colored dark media and print in white and color in a single pass. This will work with images, this will work with multiple designs, but there are more things that you need to keep in mind when you create your designs. So we will cover that in another video. This video was just to show you how to quickly install the printer driver, the standard printer driver, how to set it up on your computer, and how to print your first print with white toner on a black sheet of paper right from a standard software like Microsoft Word. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave us a thumbs up below and make sure you follow the channel. We will have a playlist linked that is featuring all videos on this printer, so you can browse through that, and we will continuously release more videos about that printer and the fantastic opportunities it holds for you. For today, I say thanks for watching and see you next time.